Premier, the announcement today, I guess the obvious question would be, it's an announcement, as you acknowledged, has been made here several times before. Why should people in Corner Brook and around the province believe that you won't be back in a year or two or three making a similar announcement?
Well, it's a good question, but the difference between this announcement today, it really is part of what the announcement that we made on January the 20th of putting in place a long-term care. Big, big difference here, though, is that the wheels are now in motion. There is money attached to this to put the request for proposals in place for your advisor, and then this will lead into, which is what will be a very significant infrastructure investment in for Western Newfoundland, and that's the Corner Brook Healthcare Campus. So it's a 5 to 6 year project, significant investment. The difference today is there's actually money attached to this.
In terms of the number of beds that will be in the actual hospital, that will be reduced from the existing hospital. And of course, when you combine it with long term, there will be an increase in beds. Are you concerned at all that as we look down the road, whether it be a decade or 2 decades from now, there may be a need for acute care beds that won't be available?
No concern at all, because what we know with healthcare, the advancements that we made, in particular surgery as an example, there are new methods and new ways that surgeries are developed. So length of stays in acute care facilities are lower than they are, you know, in the past. So we, with the long-term care site, the important thing is having people that need a certain type of care, be it long-term care, acute care, that we have the appropriate facility. And the enhancements in long-term care allows that to happen. Currently, as you know, there's over 30% of our acute care population that requires long-term care, and that's not available. So when you look at the overall campus in particular, there is a significant increase in the either acute care beds and long-term care beds when you combine those two together.
As of April of 2016, there was $40 million spent on the hospital. How much money has been spent on it now to date?
Couldn't give you the exact number right now of what's been spent. What we do know is that today's announcement will feed into budget announcements, putting in place the advisor, putting in place, getting the right group of people that will be put in place. But let's not forget, phase one of this is a long-term care, making sure that we have that facility as phase one, so we then feed into the overall campus. There is significant investment. When this project reaches maximum construction period time, we're going to see tens of millions of dollars spent in this area. So this logistically alone, this will create quite a bit of economic impetus, but also meeting the acute and long-term care needs of people in Western Newfoundland.
Do you know how much money your government has spent on it since last April?
Couldn't tell you what the exact number is right now from a finance point of view, but what we've done is we've done a complete analysis on where we need to be. We know that this project, the way we are actually proceeding with this right now, there will be public sector employees, government will own the building, it's over a 30-year period, and there's about a 7% savings for the people of this province. So this is the best procurement model that we have available to us. It will create savings, it will create certainty, it will de-risk, it will take out cost overruns, and right now we will see a significant investment in infrastructure in Western Newfoundland and meeting the needs of the healthcare needs of people in our province.
This is another P3 project now. How confident are you that this is the way to go, given, you know, that we haven't had any yet, except for these two projects right now? How confident are you in this model?
We've done extensive research of what happened in other provinces. There's lots and lots of successes when you go outside of Newfoundland and Labrador. The big difference here in what the Conservatives and what the prior administration was talking about, they were not going to own this building. They were not going to staff it with public sector workers. This government will own this building from day one. It will be owned for the 30-year period. It will be turned over in good condition, because the maintenance and of this building will be done by the designer and the contractor. This building will be turned over in good shape in 30 years' time. The government will own it, the people of Newfoundland will own it, and the public sector employees will provide the much-needed healthcare services for the residents of Western Newfoundland.
I know you obviously can't talk about financing and funding because of the RFP thing and what the design may be, but do you have a ballpark figure about how much government expects to spend on this project by the time the doors are finally open?
It'll be significant. It's early days, and this is the reason why we put in place, make sure that we have the appropriate people here that can help us guide through this. Government as it exists today has not done this type of project at this type of scope, at this magnitude. So it's important that we reach out and get the people that have done this before. This is what today's announcement will be. And the overall, what the budget will be, we know it will be significant. But we also know that there's a tremendous need out there. And we really need to put, takeaway in all of this is we have to put in place the types of facilities that actually meet the needs of people that are looking either for long-term or acute care services in Western Newfoundland.
One of the things the former government talked about a lot as they were making their announcements and re-announcements was the changes in technology, the changes required services and whatnot. How confident are you that you'll be able to maintain the plan that you outlined here today when 2 years, 3 years from now there may be different changes, whether it be technological or otherwise?
Yeah, when you build buildings, of course, there's always, you always incorporate the room for advancements in technology. As an example, the way we were building this hospital 20 years ago, radiation services would have been much different than they are today. I mentioned earlier about surgical suites. It would have been much different 20 years ago than they are today. So we've taken the best practices, the information that comes from those best practice models, we've incorporated that and made provision for that we can see we will allow for progress and new evolutions in healthcare. They happen very quickly, and it's very difficult to predict where we will be in 20 to 30 years, but making sure that we put in place provisions and allowing for those new technologies to be included in the acute care model, and indeed the long-term model as well, that's important. We've been able to do that within this scope.
A former premier once said, Premier Marshall, in fact, said he would not leave public life until there was steel in the ground at that facility. How much of a guarantee are you making when you say 2019 will be the start of construction of that hospital? How much of a guarantee are you willing to give to the people that will be a target hit?
Well, I've also known that in public life right now, there are many factors that can actually claim that, but I will guarantee you this, that I have a group of people here that's standing behind me, a caucus, we have a cabinet, and we have the will and the courage of the residents of Western Newfoundland. They're going to make this happen. I'm going to lead it, but the residents of Newfoundland and Labrador will help lead this in conjunction with the people that I have standing here with me today. This is going to be a reality for people in Western Newfoundland and Labrador.
I know that the PP project starts with the design phase, but of course you already have a bit of an idea as to what you would like to see in this new hospital, the shopping list. How much of the old designs from the previous governments those designs were used in this process?
We've seen some significant changes. We've seen this within the long-term care site as an example. We've been able to take rehab services. We've been able to take palliative care, move that into the appropriate place, and that being in long-term care. So there's been some significant changes in the when you look at the layout and the way the flow of healthcare services would be in the long-term care site, and we'll see some of that. But we also need to make sure that we allow and we put in place that when people come in, when contractors and people have done this, we need to be able to make provisions available for people for innovative and creative ideas too. And there's room for that in this building as well.
Have your government looked at any design plans?
Now, I have not seen any design plans. There's been an extensive amount of work that's been done within the engineering department, within the healthcare, within transportation works on all of this. But the commitment today is to get this done. The advisory group will go in place right now. This will lead into the due diligence that's required on this very significant infrastructure investment.
QP has said, you know, this approach is like using a credit card to pay for the hospital, the passes. And they're concerned that some of the maintenance work, they're going to cross over with the maintenance work that's going to be expected in the contract. What do you say to the unions and their concerns? If they want a meeting with the government to discuss all that, what do you say to them?
The number one concern on the minds of people in Western Newfoundland, indeed the people of Newfoundland and Labrador, is that they have the best available infrastructure to meet the services, the critical services, including healthcare. That's what they are looking for. That's what people are asking me. That's what they're asking me and asking our cabinet for. They want us to respond to the healthcare needs. Right now, this keeps in place public sector workers to deliver these services. So it's and many of them will be QP employees. So I guess when you get the leadership of QP coming out and saying this is not the right approach, well then, you know, I would ask some questions, because there's a lot of QP employees that are going to be using the services of this healthcare facility. There's going to be a lot of QP members that will actually be working in this facility. So maybe that's a discussion that the leadership will need to have with their membership, because people are coming up to me on a daily basis and asking and saying that they want to see this government in